Welcome to Crysis 2. Episode 8.
Achieved with CryEngine.
All right, let's do this. We're at the final mission. Let's go for a walk in the park. Double check, make sure we're recording, audio levels. Wonderful day for a walk in the park. What's up? Objective, infiltrate south with the whole ship and subvert the spore. Reach the sphere.
Oh man, look at the calving on this thing.
Huh?
Alcatraz, listen. All this bedrock is just hanging off the lithoship structure. It's completely unstable. Could go at any time. You gotta watch for stress fracturing. There, see what I mean?
I think he knows. That first pinger boss fight back at like
I didn't get the there's like 2,000 nanocrystals free that I forgot to get the after that defeating that boss fight. I didn't pick those up, but anyway, we got enough for this cloak cracker. Now we'll be able to somewhat see where the cloak enemies at the final fight. They're cloak enemies, and so that'll be very effective for defeating the enemies for the final fight.
Thank you.
Thank you.
in Alcatraz. We don't have much time. Whatever you did back there in the hive, do it again. Good luck, man.
Tactical options available. Thank you.
There is one collectible that we didn't get in the, it was locked off in the sudden impact, I think it's the second level. After I complete the game, I'll probably just go back to that area, go back to the level after the credit roll and everything, and go with that, get that, and then maybe go through and show the different collectible objectives, photos and artwork, and maybe read the email or something, but we'll do that. We'll do that afterwards. Thank you.
no time to stay and fight, man. You gotta get back in there. But make sure you tool up before you... Oh.
Here's where that having that being able to see the cloaked enemies is gonna work out in our favor here. Alright, infiltrate south of the ship and subvert the spore, enter the structure. Thank you. ammunition or nothing because of the damn... You're shitting me. How the fuck...
Listen, Alcatraz, the spore is reactive. It's a protective system. You need to look for cyborg cabling in the walls. Use the suit to wrench some of it loose.
Will you ever shut up?
So too. Remember me. But the Hargreave was right. The suit changes all the rules. They got inside me. The Ceph, they got inside. I had to break the link to the suit, or lose control for good. And you were there, in front of me, dying in front of me.
Huh?
Man, I had to take the chance, give you the chance to finish what I started. It was our only hope. Look at that.
How
not just
do?
New York, not just Lynchan.
Pretty good, huh?
See, the Ceph have been around forever, man. And they built everywhere. See, we won here today, but this thing isn't even close to over. You and me, Marine, we don't get to die just yet. We gotta go back. Back where we're needed.
Am I reaching the force recon, Marine? Just recovered at Central Park? Beware of Jacob Hargreaves' nanoshell.
Rax, that you?
Wait.
You're next.
I'm adjusting the feed. Allow me to introduce myself. Karl Ernstash, at your service. And you are?
Superstar.
They call me Prophet.
Bravo. Bravo, Crysis. Crytek. Crytek game design team. One of my favorite, not only one of my favorite first-person shooter franchises of all time, but also Crysis, this game. Probably one of my favorite first-person shooters of all time. Got a cool storyline, great graphics, cool navigation. Cool variety of firearms, upgrades, mana suit abilities. The mana suit upgrades are really cool too, to have be able to have different resources, be able to change up your different play style depending upon what upgrades you know, give yourself. So it's like every time you go through and you play this, you can like, you know, change up your play style, maybe go more stealth, maybe go guns. But I usually like to do a variety of like stealth and mainly focus on guns blazing, but also like a lot of stealth. So when you're playing on the harder difficulty levels, you want to get that stealth advantage going into when you start flipping your engage in combat. Great voice acting. The voice acting for Prophet And the other, and even though the other voice actors, really good work on the voice acting. It's really cool to play this with the RTX technology and the enhanced graphical fidelity. Yeah, I think the whole idea of this, well, this was what, released 2011 or like 11 years ago, this was originally released. And I really enjoyed the first Crysis and then the Crysis Warhead, but this whole, like, especially currently, on the trend of the last maybe 6-7 years with the, like with titles like the Far Cry series, like Far Cry 2 and then Far Cry 3, that really basically, in terms of first-person shooters, started popularizing the idea of open map games. And I enjoy a lot of open map games. That's the structure, but also some of my favorite games are just the simple level design. You go even go like back to the like the late 90s with Doom and Quake and Blood. Monolith was making really good games with just, you know, like Blood and No One Lives Forever 1 and 2. And gameplay is like, it's supposed to be fun. If the gameplay isn't any good, if it doesn't, like, the open map structure of a game, or if it's just more like from point A objective from point A to point B, if the gameplay isn't any fun, then what's the point? I mean, so it's like you can play like an open map game, but if like traversing and doing objective, when you go to the objective, it's not. That also has to do with world building. I mean, you can do really good world building like this, like with more like smaller maps, but they still give you a range of different approaches and strategies from, you know, engaging in combat, where you give you options, the choices, your different abilities, weapon upgrades, and all the different resources that they give you as an individual playing the game. So I think the open map structure, and now you've seen a lot of games that are kind of, like, especially in terms of the first person shooter genre, that are going back to kind of like more like arena combat, where you go from arena to arena, kind of like Doom 2016 had that structure, and as well as Doom Eternal, even though those are kind of more open map, they're more open areas, more larger levels. But yeah, I was like, if you're having, if the combat's fun, it doesn't really matter whether it's an open map or a smaller objective-based map, smaller map design. If the combat, I mean, if you're, you know, you can only have engage in combat in one location at a time. I think it's kind of an illusion, like the idea that you got these open maps and you got like a lot of stuff. Like, I like the Just Cause games. I love the Just Cause games, but a lot of that, especially like collectibles, they don't add anything except you're just like going to look to find the like, to add like to the list that says collectibles on the screen, and it's like you just go and picking up the same objects like in 200 different locations. It's kind of tedious, you know, and especially for someone like a completionist or someone who likes to be thorough and like exploring, it adds to exploring, but when it's overdone, it's kind of like, you know, that, you know, when open map structure becomes where you're just adding like stuff to find, but it doesn't really add anything. Like, there are certain games where the like the collectibles are like where you can find like upgrades, or you're finding something that adds to like your ability to increase your upgrades or your firearms, or something that's useful, not just something to like check off on the list. But anyway, back to this is an amazing game. Looking forward to see what they do with Crysis 4. We'll be playing Crysis 3 here. That'll be cool to see what Crysis 3 looks like with ray tracing technology as well. We'll have more game studios focusing on quality, and you can just tell, like, when you play a computer game, whether it's a first-person shooter or another genre of computer game, you can tell when you're playing it if the game, whoever designed it, was actually designing it because they love to design games and they enjoy doing what they do, or if they're just they're just in the game design or in the business of gaming just to get a paycheck. You can tell when you play a game, you can tell whether or not the team that designed it actually enjoy doing what they do, or if they're just doing something to get a paycheck. It shows, and that's the same with music and all the art forms of entertainment. That's even in the quality of business, you know, working, whether whatever kind of industry it is. Gotta be about quality. Get it up the standards, raise the standards. Keep getting better. Keep getting better, making things better. Oh, and the music in all these Crysis games is just amazing. Compositions of music. They really align the music themes with, like, different... Like, depending upon the level of the map or what the world, the map theme and the world design, they really... Crytek, the soundtrack for these games is just, it just aligns up so well with the actual feel of the game and, you know, like the combat, the different parts of the game. Crysis 2 is a real world example for not compromising your art. If they had stayed on course and focused on vision and kept and instead of compromising and attempting to appeal to the console market and downgrading their product, if they would have stayed focused on the PC and then ported that a version of just worked on the Crysis 2 from the PC built it from the PC on up, then they could have ported that to a Crysis 2 to a console version. You know, we might have already been playing Crysis 4. Decisions like that, you know, it's like whether it's music, you know, any type of entertainment, or even working at a business, maintenance, whatever it is, you know, focus on quality, focus on standards, focus on being the best. Sometimes you have to go against the trend. Sometimes you just have to keep on pushing forward. Despite everybody else, maybe as they're going in, it's going in a direction. It's a short-term money game. You gotta balance that out. You still gotta maintain the most priority. Have a long-term vision of whatever it is you do, like whether it's art, music, video games, sports, athletics. Focus. Onward and upward. Thank you for watching that episode. Hope you experienced that entire playthrough. Had fun playing that again. That looks really the remastered version of that. First time I played that remastered version of this game. Amazing. Great work. Great work, Crytek. Alright, thank you for watching. Fighting a good fight. Peace. I think we'll do some extras. I think we'll go, maybe we'll go find a missing collectible maybe. Right after this. Be kind. Be brave. Be strong. And well, what do we have here? Huh. Power of being able to go back into the game at a previous game save location, man.
Seth Rosenberg, this is Tier 7. Getting perimeters. Set to probe.
Gotta get the last collectible, bro. You get my wife.
All clear over here. Report in. Huh? Ah!
Collectible, collectible. Where are all the collectibles? City taxi cab. All right, our mission is done here. We've got all the collectibles. are at the collectables. All right, we'll just go through these, see what these look like. If you want to check these out too, if you're the game unlocks, you will unlock a game a video for each as you go through the game. Flashbacks, you can watch those if you want, replay those, and then musical scores for the entire game. This is cool. If you want to like listen to different songs, soundtrack's amazing in this game. So, and we have the collectibles, New York souvenirs. We've got some artwork. First level, second chance, sudden impact. Seeing some of the concept art before they actually built it for the actual game. Cool concept art for the aliens. Yeah, just cycling through these really, it gives you an idea. It's like it just recaps how, like, just the variety, the sheer amount of variety from map to map is really cool. How they, like, they just get, each one has their own theme, and they each has, like, it's a grounded sense of, like, you're actually at a different location. It just, there's so much, like, variety in the different areas. Yeah, that's such a cool, that's so cool, like visually seeing that, especially in the game. It's just seeing like an entire park the Central Park just like lifting up out of the ground like that. All right, those are the souvenirs. We have dog tags. Professor Nathan Gould, Lawrence Barnes, Prophet, Commander Dominique Lockhart, the AOL, Lieutenant Tara Strickland, Sakura Cherry, Colonel Sherman Barkley, the Badass, Jacob Hargreaves, another A-hole, Trino, Bro, Alcatraz, Seth Stalker, Seth Grunt, Seth Bevy, Seth Pinger, U.S. Marines, civilians, and infected civilians. We have the vehicle keys. So, yeah, the amount of detail, especially for like 2011, the amount of over 11 years ago, the amount of detail that Crytek put into the character models and the vehicles and just the world building was really, really good in this game. Even back then, even graphically, even though they didn't use their optimal graphical capabilities back then. It was a cell APC, cell helicopter, alien dropship, alien gunship. You can tell this is the thoughtfulness. And it's like really the thoughtful details, like on all these, like these different, like just the creative thoughtfulness to like make these different types of alien. Like the gunship here. Look at that. That's really cool. So I had to like this incorporating technology and like hovering abilities with the look of it, the stylized chrome looking. The buses with an American flag on that. You might see those in real life. Wait a minute, let's see that again. And the email conversation. I don't know if I'm going to read these, but I may go to scroll through these if you Lockhart files complaint. The Crytek executive board. How many are there? How many of these? Is that all of them? Maybe I'll read these. And then from cell oversight secretaries to site commander to Lockhart in crisis. Board responds. Site commander Lockhart addressed to special advisor Tara Strickland. Special Advisor Tara Strickland to Site Commander Lockhart the Asshole. From cell oversight secretaries to site commander Lockhart, song. From Crynet Executive Board to Site Commander Lockhart in Crisis Zone. Archive 22nd of March 2021 from Lieutenant Commander D. Lockhart. What? Huh? Archive 28th of March 2021, Crynet Executive Board to the Lieutenant Commander Lockhart, the SMO. From Jacob Hargreaves, Site Commander Lockhart, versus Zone. From Crynet Executive Board, Lieutenant Anderson. From Jacob Hargreaves, to Nathan Gould. Well, Nathan, here we are. If you're reading this, then I'm finally dead and the tasks that are left fall to you. The nanosuit has reached its full potential. The coating changes necessary for it to modify. The spores are in place. This will prevent the rejection mechanisms we have encountered so far in the Ceph nanoflow from blocking or limiting replication. The reversal should become total. The spore is, in essence, becoming a vector against alien tissue instead of human. It was once my intention to wear the suit myself and deliver this weapon to the heart of the Ceph systems personally. It seemed only fitting. I stole Promethean nanotech fire from them at Tunguska and gifted it to the human race over the following century. I woke them at Lingshan that I should be the one to send them back into oblivion had an almost poetic resonance, a fulfillment of long and heavy responsibility. But the stage is set. I have done all I can. What remains is left to you and Alcatraz. Good luck. There's no such thing as luck. Nathan, my sincere best wishes go with you. So when we play Crysis 3, we're going to get a lot more backstory about this. Kind of sets the stage for that, not finding out about Lingshan and where the nanotech technology came from and the aliens and everything. All that will be most of that will be revealed during the story of when we're playing Crysis 3. And that's also, I was talking about thoughtfulness. It's really thoughtful the way the story and the whole theme of the Crysis series as a franchise, story-wise, it's a really cool story. And all right, that will do it for this playthrough of Crysis 2 Remastered. Once again, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. I appreciate your attention. And hopefully we'll see you in the Crysis 3 Remastered playthrough. Keep fighting the good fight. Peace. Be strong. Be kind. Be brave.